So, no, sorry. Yeah, it is. It is a Ludwig player, as all Bowser Jr. Players will correct me. It's not Bowser Jr. It's Iggy or Wendy or Roy or whatever.
Yeah, you gotta get specific. They go by these names for a reason. In Zurak, we're gonna be playing this box still. We are still on the winners' pools. Hopping right onto Pokemon Stadium 2.
Interesting to see how Ketchup approaches this. Of course, Fox's mid-percent combos are very, very good. So between 30 and 90% has to be very wary. The Clown Car might be his ticket out, but he's using it very often early.
And Zurak is doing such a good job catching up with these arrows and these tilts, forcing him off stage once more. Ketchup already at a huge disadvantage, and the narrative jab is a true combo. Will he get ledge trapped for the fifth time in a row? And Ketchup is stuck on the edge of this Pokemon Stadium stage.
Finally makes it back and returns the favor of the rapid jab. Gets him up to 43%, and the down throw does not have any easy follow-ups, but gets him with one hit of the F smash, and Zurak had to be holding his breath there.
He's able to find his way out of it, and here comes the edge guard. Ledge trap, I should say. He's able to find it, but that nair into up smash, you gotta watch out for that one, especially if you're Ketchup, because being a big character like that, you're super vulnerable to it.
Yeah, Fox's nair has almost zero landing lag, and if you have your motions telegraphed, that's an easy kill for anyone with half a read on you.
And then here comes the Koopa Bomb. Gotta get reflected, so Ketchup's gotta be careful. And you see Zurak right now, he's comfortable using his lasers.
Yeah, the earlier Zurak can shine away or reflect the Mecha Koopas, the better. And gets caught with a cannonball. That almost killed.
That almost killed, but he's trying to use that. He's trying to use that two-frame opportunity he's got. Remember, Fox's recovery is easily exploitable. But if there's one thing that Ketchup's got to be careful of, is that jab has so much end lag.
Yeah, Mecha Koopa comes out, although Zurak smartly goes to the other side of the stage. Not even waiting for that to be a problem.
He's able to get away from it right now, but right now he's trying to run up and use that bear, but the up air from Zurak actually is able to catch him up for a little more. He reflects the Mecha Koopa once more, but Ketchup. You just, like, anytime I look at him, he's already at disadvantage in his own cannonball being used against him.
Yeah, a lot of betrayals coming out. Not even going for the down smash two frame, but this time waits all the F smash and lands very fast. Fox, the fastest faller in the game, and that back air will kill.
Yeah, I mean, he's actually going to be alive for now, trying to look for an opportunity. Ketchup knows if he gets a grab, he should be able to take it, but Zurak's going to have a hard time catching out this stock, and he's going to get read out by that cart. And here's the problem. Fox trying to close that stock. Okay, well, scratch that.
He just converted off of Ketchup's Mecha Koopa. What intricate matchup knowledge and what great item play coming out. And already a few uppers will put him at 56.
And see, 72 force him off already. He's going for the hard read, but thankfully Zurak is able to dodge it out, intelligently using his Firefox upwards instead of directly on stage. And here we go, using the clown car. He gets the conversion. That's gonna kill Ketchup.
Ketchup played the angles to perfection there, and after falling behind early from these ledge traps, finally has a window back into this game. We're even at 8%.
He's able to use it, and both them at 8%. But speaking of that, here comes the up airs. Remember, Fox, like you said earlier, is the fastest baller, so he's so vulnerable to these combos.
Now, how will he get back in this game? Parries the first hit of that multi-hit down air, but Ketchup has more hits in store.
Gets grabbed out. He went for a tech chase situation, but thankfully Ketchup was able to shield. But both of them are throwing aerials left and right at each other. And this Mega Koopa, the clown cart, is posing some problems for Zurak, because every time he tries to go for a roll of some sort, then the Koopa cart is just catching him out every single time.
Yeah, if he can't get the shine on it early as he did in the first or second stocks, just nothing he can do about it there. And that just siphons off, just puts the red and yellow tape out of a certain section of the stage. Almost nothing he can do.
Mm-hmm, but this time, Ketchup is actually going to be the one in trouble, because at 100%, that is prime percentage for a fastfall nair into an up smash.
I'm just going to go for the up smash there, but into the rapid jab. That does kill at about 20% later, so if he can get it unstale.
And you can't keep doing that. That might be able to take it. And he's going to take it. He tried to use the air dodge cancel, but Ketchup coming back hard in that game.
Yeah, Ketchup fell behind very early due to a series of lead traps from Zurak, and almost lost a second stock, went up to 157. But with that rage and a few well-timed, you know, Mecha Koopas, and without throwing them out to a point where Zurak could reflect the cannonballs and Mecha Koopas immediately, getting smarter about some of the zoning play, that was his path back.
That's an adaptation that you need to do, and Ketchup pulling it off. Such an impressive play by him. But Zurak, hopefully he's got a plan for game number two, because he did have it in the bag. But It just felt like that he's being overwhelmed, and definitely the fact that his recovery is being exploited. So game number two, Ketchup versus Zurak.
Yeah, Ludwig, not one to be slept on. Low tier? Who says this character's a low tier?
Everyone.
We in SoCal know better.
I guess it's SoCal, right? They're the ones who bring up all the weird picks. But speaking of that, Ketchup doing such a good job. This is like an entirely different game. And there's also one thing that I didn't get to see in that previous game that Zurak really wanted. He wanted to go for those up tilt chains.
He did. And of course, Bowser Jr., if you do hit that cart, it does lesser knockback. But he just hit Ludwig himself, and that did additional knockback, and he fell out.
Able to get himself out of that. Here it comes. These are the mix-ups that Zurak seems to have a hard time dealing with. This is the clown cart that Ketchup is driving towards him, and he gets the one at a fair. I think he definitely wanted to go for the reversal and use that backer to kill.
Clown cart's out of trouble, but going to be eating a few lasers. Does shine the Mecha Koopa, so he's going to be getting rid of it. Neutralizes the threat.
And he uses it once more. Ketchup almost got the fair follow-up, but he's got to be careful. And he calls out the jump. He's able to air dodge cancel out of the way, but once again, Zurak in the back end.
Yeah, makes it back to the stage before the clown car can explode, but has to be wary of the cannonballs. Uses the time to shine. Caught by the rapid jab. This might kill. It does. Zurak, they're going to be the first one out of the stock.
Does take in Ketchup, flexing a little bit with those insta-Z drops, and he's able to find a way. It's, like I said earlier, it's the clown car that's posing so much problem for Zurak because it's such a mix-up, and when he gets caught up by those up-airs, that's like three or four more following your way.
It is, and when Ketchup is vertically moving as well as horizontally moving, you cannot be sure what part of Ketchup you are going to hit. You will take less damage if you hit the cart instead of Ludwig himself. Finally gets the opportunity to get an exposed Ludwig, but doesn't even get a strong punish.
Mm-hmm. And the clown card itself, it can be canceled into a jump, so he's got to be super careful. It's all these mix-ups that are happening left and right. Ketchup doing the best as he can. He's got 140%. He's going to re-grab the ledge, though, and you can't do that against Zurak.
Yeah, two frames with the down smash. Zurak was facing backwards the entire time. Perhaps wanted a back air at the ledge, but that'll be of no problem to him. Almost wanted to go for the F smash and interrupted him during the startup. That one will only get the shield, but the clown cart is going to be sending him towards the corner.
Mm-hmm. He's got no air dodge, but he's able to safely make it back. He's going to go ahead and use that jab. I think Ketchup's going to go ahead and get a little bit of punish from that one, but if you're Ketchup right now, you're not too mad about that, but here come the combos from Zurak. Hopefully he's going to be able to snap back, and he gets the down tilt, trying to go for the back air attempt, but nothing so far.
Ketchup finally gets him back off stage with the downer, has Mecha Koopa in hand, gets rid of it. Throws it straight downwards, was not in a position to punish the illusion.
Yeah, what a risky illusion. Here comes the con. This is what Zurak had such a hard time dealing with. And he gets the nair, doesn't read it, doesn't even go for it. He's actually going to get the dash attack part. No up smash just yet. It actually caught him out.
Yeah, he shined that Mecha Koopa a bit earlier, and his own Mecha Koopa betrayed him. Although it's going to be Ketchup who secures the kill as he returns to Sage, and now has to take advantage of the rage.
This is the problem that Zurak deals with. He gets comboed up just like that, but this time he calls it out. He knew that Ketchup likes to jump from that using the clown cart, so he calls it out using the up smash, and he needed that crucial read if he wants to stay in this game.
And now Ketchup, 57% to his 8, is playing with a bit of a lead, perhaps something he wasn't doing in game one, and going to have to see how he uses the clown cart a bit differently.
And Zurak trying to adapt using his lasers, trying to get something down, but 60%, here we go. He's firing back a little bit. He's got to get something down if he wants to stay in this. And a great parry. He knew exactly what Ketchup was going for.
Two up airs in a row. He is facing backwards again. So again, he's looking for the bear, gets it there, and he's going to go for the down smash. No, he isn't.
This is melee? What's going on? He tried to go for an edgehog, and he thought Ketchup was going to jump again. He tries to get the up smash read. He's jumping away from the clown cart. Zurak's got to be careful. He maneuvered just around it, just so he can get the back air, and Ketchup gets hit up by another back air. Zurak takes game number two, and moving on to a final one.
Yeah, real tense moments there, a nail biter from Zurak, but after relentless ledge pressure, and just some well-timed Mecha Koopas got rid of him, crucially reflected one of them back, and he's gonna find a window back into this game. It's 1-1.
Really close. Ketchup had it. It's just that Zurak slowly started to adapt in some very good decisions using that rage. On stock number two, was able to get as much damage as possible, and a great read on the up smash, knowing that Ketchup was going to jump up from the clown cart. Both these players are starting to get a little bit of read in each other, so hopefully we're going to see an explosive game number three.
No doubt. Ludwig is going to be the pick still. Zurak sticking with his tried and true fox, although switching up the costume, that might be a bit of a mentality shift. Does not want to repeat those same early stock woes.
A And just, oh, very interesting interaction coming out already. And here comes the jab catching out for Zurak. He's for a little more damage, and this time he uses the bear from ledge.
Zurak is trapped in the air, but Fox, of course, a fast follower, so will be returning to stage without too much of a problem. If he can manage to avoid getting combos, as a lot of fast followers do, he might be okay here.
And it's Ketchup doing a really good job forcing Zurak to go for these full hops instead of the short hop just because of his clown card is forcing up that much pressure. So Zurak definitely respecting, trying to use his laser to force out Ketchup to come closer to him. And he jabs, he does parry it. He does get a little bit of the counter back, but here comes, and he's actually getting a little bit more damage off of that one.
Once again, he is facing backwards, so this bear perhaps a bit telegraphed, but it is working.
I mean, it's auto-cancelable, it's safe on shield. He went for the up smash read, and this time they trade on it. So Zurak happily gonna deal with it. He's looking for these up smashes. Ketchup's gotta be careful, but it's not careless at all. He's just so confident that his side special will work out for him.
Illusions to the other side of the stage, and good timing just pummeled him enough to the point where that Mecha Koopa had enough timing to get back and latch on, but gonna be caught with a tongue, and that almost killed.
Yeah, 153%. He's got to be careful. Oh, great tech. Ketchup gets the nice. He gets red on Zurak. Yeah. Takes stock number one, and that's crucial if he's able to run away with this rage.
Run up smash going to be it for him, but Zurak now has a bit of rage and already 26% immediately. The clown cart with a beginning hitbox responding.
Yeah, it was the empty hop clown cart that caught Zurak off guard, but Ketchup at 46%. Zurak really needs to be careful and not get hit by them. He's using his dash attack to catch it out, and he knows that Ketchup likes to roll backwards. So potentially something that Ketchup needs to be careful, but here comes the rapid jab and the lasers to quickly follow up. Zurak is patiently playing this game, knowing that he needs to slowly chip away at Ketchup until he's at that percentage for a fastball nair, and then finally he can get something off of that one.
Now goes for the fair. He is 100% up, and Zurak does not want to get cocky here. Has to keep playing it safe. Easy nairs, easy back airs, some things that are safe on shield rather than a hard read.
And he went for it once more. He's got to be careful on you. Air dodge a little too early there, my guy. Ketchup gets his stock with an unfortunate SD. Zurak, he gets... Oh, my God. I thought that F smash was about to kill.
It almost did. Gets caught with a clown card, though, and doesn't tech. Almost going to be sent right back off the stage. Firefox to make it back.
And the fair from the ledge once more. He's got to be careful. He's get clipped out once more. Ooh, he uses the shine to stall, and here come the up tilt chains, but thankfully, the Mecha Koopa is able to break him out, and he's able to get a kill.
Yeah, converts off of the Mecha Koopa, not for the first time this set. He's been getting these very, very often, but lands with a dare, and now Ketchup has to be careful on how he approaches.
Mm-hmm, and those reads coming in right now, Ketchup has to be careful. One fastball nair into an up smash will take it, especially at 116%. Doesn't matter how heavy you are. As this Ludwig is not working out, and he lands the grab, though. He's getting the percentage down. Here come the up air chains. Oh, he went for it, but a great reversal from Zurak.
Yeah, he just up specialed right into Zurak's waiting up air, and Zurak was all too prepared for it. Had it covered the first time, and the second time it will connect.